सोशल साइंस टीचर ऑफ ग्रेड 10. इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट इम्पैक्ट ऑफ ब्रिटिश रूल इन इंडिया. अंडर दैट वी हैव डिस्कस एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव एंड जुडिशियल सिस्टम बाय फैसिलिटेटिंग इन दैट सिविल सर्विस, जुडिशियल सिस्टम, पुलिस सिस्टम एंड मिलिट्री सिस्टम. एंड वी वुड टॉक अबाउट लैंड टैक्सेस पॉलिसी. अंडर दैट राइट परमानेंट जमींदारी सिस्टम वी हैव फिनिश्ड. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डील यू हियर अबाउट महलवारी सिस्टम एंड रायतवारी सिस्टम. महलवारी सिस्टम, द कंपनी गवर्नमेंट एंटर टू अग्रीमेंट एट द लेवल ऑफ महल्स, एट द लेवल ऑफ महल्स इन हियर. सो मेक श्योर दैट अप टू 1858, 57 एंड 58 the British government was not ruling, British East India Company was ruling with India. And with the regard, what are the mahals, with the regard payment of land taxes, that is, it was introduced first in Uttar Pradesh and some part of, or the many parts we can say, Madhya Pradesh, Punjab and Delhi. What do you mean by mahal here? So, mahal means taluk. Who introduced or who implemented? R.M. Bird, James Thomas implemented Mahalwari system in India. These were difference in the implementation of this system. It was from region to region, it was different. From one region to other region, the Mahalwari system was quite different. And the big and small zamindars were part of this system. And moreover, since the company officials fixed more land tax than expected production the fields. Here one negative things we can say here, the company officials, what they are fixed on the land, the production of land was very less compared to that they are expecting more. So due to this reason, many zamindars, means who are farmers, and they lose their ownership of lands. That was a negative feedback we can say. Raitwari system, it was introduced in the year of 1792. Raitwari system was first implemented in Brahmahal region by Alexander Reed, and this system was later implemented in Madras and Mysore region, that is, we can call as Tamil Nadu and Karnataka region. It was by Thomas Munray who was introduced the Raitwari system, is that is a Thomas Munray. Under this system, both farmers and company were directly linked. Before that, what are the, we were discussing permanent and Mahalwari system. Farmers are the peasants and company were not directly linked, right? But in Raitwari system, farmer and company were directly linked. The tiller of the land was recognized as owner of land. Who was the owner of land? Who was the tiller? Tiller ante helidrelli uluvavane bhumiya odeya ante heli karitare. The owner had to pay 50% of produce as land taxes to the company government. How much they have to pay? What are they are producing? In that 50% of the things or the income, they have to pay it as a tax to a company. The land tax was tenure. It was a fixed for the year of 30 years. After the 30 years, the tax could be revived after that tenure. So what were the objectives or the, what are the, sorry, it is not objective. What were the impacts of British land tax system? See, the main thing is that the British East India Company or the British company introduced many land tax system in India. But its object is only one, to earn profit for company or East India Company. They were not seeing anything of farmers, we can say here. So they were not bothered. Here, a new class of zamindar who exploited farmers was created. So new class of people has created here, that is zamindar, who exploited the farmers. And the farmers were the subject to the exploitation. The major thing is who was the subjected here for the exploitation means farmers of zamindar, and sometimes zamindar also become a landless slowly because they could not have to pay the what are the taxes or the taxes or the revenue which was given for British East India Company. Land become a commodity of loans, could be rice mortgaging lands. Here land were actually, when we are thinking land for what, it is for the purpose of agriculture. Here it has become commercialized, or it is a commodity on the basis of land. They are the people who are the money lenders, were they are saukaras, they were giving amount or loans to people. So what they are doing, they are mortgaging lands. What is the meaning of mortgaging? ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರಲ್ವಾ ಅಡ್ವಿಡೋದು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು, ಆ ಅಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರು ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್, ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರಲ್ವಾ ಅಡ್ವಿಡೋದು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು, ಆ ಅಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರು ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಪತ್ರಗಳನ್ನ ಅಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಸಾಲಗಳನ್ನ ತಗೊಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರು. ವೆನ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ರೀಪೇ ದ ಲೋನ್ ಟು ದ ಪರ್ಸನ್, ಆಟೋಮೆಟಿಕಲಿ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ವಾಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಮನಿ ಲೆಂಡರ್ಸ್. ಮೆನಿ ಜಮೀನ್ದಾರ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ದ ಮಾರ್ಟ್ಗೇಜ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಟು ಪೇ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಸ್. Agriculture sector become commercialized. So the agriculture sector was there, no? That has become the commercialized, and British East India Company forced farmers to crops, commercial crops than food crops, because we can see on those times England, industrial revolutions was going. So they need a much more raw materials. For example, we can give as a indigo was the one thing which they are forced to produce, because what are the indigo was producing in India having a qualitatively, it was good in quality, that's the reason. Only the land they have entered, no, they have the changes after the British when they came to India, the system of education also changed. What are the changes in education system? We can see that is modern education system we are speaking. So in the modern system of education, the traditional education of Indians was in practice continuously. Certain changes occurred in the traditional education system during the rule of Muslim kings during Middle Ages. Later new changes occurred during the British rule in during 18th century. We can say new schools were started for children of British and Europeans who are living in India. The new school was started, the people who are living in India, basically they are from European and the British people. And since and one more thing, since these facilities were never extended to locals or the native Indians, we can say this was no use for them. And actually when the Warren Hastings facilitated the expansion of the modern education in India in the year of 1781, so he started this one Calcutta Madrasa. Jotham Duquesne, the British citizen, started the Calcutta Madras, and one more thing that is Sanskrit College in Bandras in the year of the 1792. And what are the Warren Hastings, the expansion of the British education in India received the special support after the appointment of Lord William Bentinck in the year of the 1828. He was elected as a Governor General of India. So Bentinck, Bentinck is appointed as a Governor General of India in the year of the 1828, he appointed Macaulay as the Member Governor General of Executive Committee. The report of education was submitted by him, that is in the year of 1835, become the base for modern education in India, which was the base for the modern education in India, we can say British education. That is the report which has submitted by the Macaulay report, we are saying, that is in the year of 1835. Actually, his policy was aimed at creation of new class people or new class of Indians who are by Indian by body, but British in intelligence and opinion and taste. Make sure that here, what are the Mekales was condition was the people who are Indian by their body, but mentally are that they are the intelligence and they should be have the opinion and taste like the British. That was the main aim of this policy. Another important development include the establishment of universities in India. The Governor General Dalhousie established universities in Calcutta, Bombay, Madras as per the suggestion of Charles Wood Commission 1854. After this, the education started becoming universalized in India. And upcoming class, I am going to speak you regarding impact of modern education in India. What are the constitutional development during the rule of East India Company? Thank you for watching video. Stay tuned to GJS. Have a great day ahead.